welcome to Ireland.
Oh, thank you. Good to be here.
The last time I was talking to you, yeah, we were having lovely tea and sandwiches.
That's true.
And you looked after us well. So tell me, the exhibition was finally launched. Your husband was honoured.
It was a great honour to have him represented in such a peaceful and really family kind of way. You know, we've come a long way in meeting Paul and Nicola, and even Paul's family came and had tea and met Gran, and it's a good honour.
It's very personal, very respectfully done. I feel it was nice that the people of Ireland were so involved in everything about the museum exhibit and even respectfully 9/11. You know, the families, and they've truly supported us.
How important is it for people to remember what happened that day? And is it unique for Ireland to try to take the lead and to remember what happened at 9/11?
Well, it is certainly for us.
Yeah,
which makes us very happy. But I think it's important that all people realize that remembrance is what, hopefully, it doesn't happen again. Yeah. That it can happen anywhere. We were someone that it happened to, but you want to remember so that you can maybe hopefully learn from it and not ever see something like this again.
Now today was a sad day for you, but it's a joyous day as well.
Very much so.
When you see, your first time, what was your first thoughts when going on to the exhibition?
A little bit of fear, you know, you want to make sure that you're as strong as the people who have gotten us through this have been. And you know, you walk in and it's bigger than what you imagined it would be, and you know, you're glad to have family and friends to get you through it. And you walk in and you kind of suck it up and tight upper lip, and it really was easy to go around and see it and appreciate, you know, everything that's been done.
It started out as we were afraid we were going to be very sad, but there was an absolute sense of warmth when we saw his helmet and his picture, and that it definitely was something that made you feel warm inside to say, there's that stuff.
Yeah.
You know, so
it made him a person as well as someone who was lost that day, and it's nice that they cared about everything, not just the helmet or the piece of steel, but who he was at home and who he was to us and to people in his community where he worked. And it's bigger than
put a face to the whole thing. You know, I think people remember then better.
Important to remember.
Oh, definitely.
I think if we forgot, we'd be in a lot of trouble when we get up there ourselves.
He was easy to remember. He's a lot of fun. Great guy. Great dad.
Heck yeah. I mean, yes.
What will you take from your trip to Ireland? What from your visit here? What will you take? What memories will you take back?
I think the fun we had leading up to it, planning it, but also the sense of the support that we've seen, hearing all about it on TV, hearing that people were so interested. Paul was filling us in that everyone was so received it so well, and that makes you feel good that they are.
Yeah, you lose one family member and you gain 100
a whole
more.
Country.
So it's been really great.
Again, how important is it for people? Now, this is a big Irish-led exhibition, but how important is it for people worldwide to remember what happened that terrible day?
I think it's important, you know, in really bad times and in tragedy like this, or tragedy we've seen over the past couple of years, you know, it's funny to see that while there may be really bad things going on and people fighting and people not respecting, you know, for every one of those, there's about 1,000 others that really do respect that what's going on is not just happening to our family or to the Smith family, but it's happening to a lot of families. And you know, you hope that by remembering the good things, the bad stuff is just something to kind of kick you back on the straight line and make sure you know, love thy neighbor and you're as good as the people we lost that day were, you know. She's not bad either. So,
I'm sure you guys are proud, folks, and I'm actually honored to talk to you. And
thank you so
to
much.
Spending more time with you.
Oh, I hope.
Did you try the Guinness here? Did you?
A couple of them to get me here today. A couple. Yeah, my dad was a big Guinness fan.
You know, she said she really needed it, you know, to get us through.
Take the shake off, and you know, gives you a little strength.
How are you going to spend your next couple of days here in Ireland?
Actually, I'm going to go up to Monaghan, see some of the aunts and uncles, and
try
then we're
going to
shop on Friday. You know,
try to get her
I'm trying to help the economy.
That'll be a good job to get stuff
done. She'll do a good job before she leaves. I can guarantee
she's helping
that.
The brewery. I'm helping the economy.
We're a good pair, you and me. Yeah.
It all helps. Well, listen, thanks very much for coming.
Thank you so much. Thank
you. I will look forward to spending a few days in the fire station.
Yes.
Oh, we'll definitely get you with the guys.
Get the phone number.
Thicken your skin before you get there.
Oh, listen, I'm a dummy old man.
If they don't pick on you, they don't like you. So hopefully they pick on you a lot.
So we look forward to seeing you.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you, folks.
Thank you.
Lovely.